Closed either. All right.
I don't know if y'all like it if enough.
Move on to another saga of Anthony Davis. He'll remain on the Pelicans for the rest. He'll remain on the Pelicans for the rest of the year after not being moved at the deadline. However, all eyes are on where he will play next season and if he commit to that thing long term. Davis spent the weekend answering where he wants to play. Take a listen to what he said.
Somebody had told me that you had mentioned maybe the Celtics being on that list. I just wanted to clarify. Are they on the list? 29 teams are on my list. Everyone's on the list.
I don't have a preferred destination. Like I said, I just want to win. You know, they ask me big market, small market. I don't care. You know, I want to win. You know, and obviously whatever team, you know, I get traded to, you know, play for it that year or whatever. If I get traded, I'm not sure. But to make the best of it, and then, you know, when free agency comes, see what happens. You know, I can tell the future, but all 29 teams are on the list.
So just to follow quick, so people who had reported, it's the Lakers and then it's Knicks.
I never gave a destination.
The man Anthony who's Davis listening has is
never
Anthony
gave
Davis.
A destination okay. Where he wants to play. Okay.
Chris, how will this AD situation play out?
Let me give AD some credit because everybody's talked about, oh, he's so uncomfortable with this. He's such a nice guy. You know he's not happy with this situation. Or he's uncomfortable because it's not his style. He handled it really well over the weekend. I thought he appeared very comfortable. He did a good job. Now, how do I think it plays out? It obviously could be the Lakers, the Knicks, or the Celtics that he is traded to. With Boston, there are people close to him that have been saying he will not sign in Boston, whether it's his dad or other people saying he won't sign there. For him to come out, I'm going to take him at his word. If he's coming out and saying Boston is on the list, Boston is a potential destination, not only next year, but long term, then I think he likely ends up in Boston. I think it all depends on Kyrie Irving. If Kyrie Irving re-signs with the Celtics, then I think Danny Ainge goes all in. He won't offer Jason Tatum initially.
Right.
But if it has to be Jason Tatum, then I think Jason Tatum will be on that block, and assuming they don't win the championship, and AD will go to Boston. If Kyrie leaves and goes to New York or somewhere else, I would not give up the farm for Anthony Davis if I'm Danny Ainge. I would not give up Jason Tatum without Kyrie Irving locked up.
No question.
If I was Danny Ainge, but I don't know if Danny will do that. Well, I think he may go all in on Kyrie, which is why
I think the Pelicans and Del Demps, former general manager, who was, by the way, fired Friday.
Yeah.
Right. Like, kind of a Friday news dump story before holiday weekend. Like, oh yeah, by the way, we're firing Del Demps. We'll see you after the All-Star break. I think if the reported deal was offered, which I was told was not what the reported deal was for the Lakers.
Well, what it was. It was like, look, you can have two or three of these guys. Like, they're not offering all of them first round picks and cap relief.
Like that wasn't happening. Regardless of which, there's so many ifs there for the Pelicans. Like you don't know what the potential for the Celtics want Anthony Davis. Yeah, I know for a fact they want him and they would make that move today if the contracts situation wasn't for the Derrick Rose rule, right? Are the Knicks gonna want him? Yeah, but okay, what happens if the Knicks don't get Kyrie and they get Kemba, but they don't get KD and they don't get the number one pick? Like then does he want to go there? I just love the Frank Pantangeli moment. You guys remember Godfather 2? Frank Pantangeli goes states, right? So he goes before the grand jury and he's supposed to out Michael Corleone as a gangster. And he sits down there and he goes, oh, Michael Corleone. No. You guys got it all wrong. We're all friends. Like all the business. We go back years. That's what Anthony Davis did. Anthony Davis sits down there and goes, like, they have massively butchered this thing, right? Between asking for demanding a trade, and then of course the dad comes out.
Who are you saying has butchered this? Anthony Davis.
Anthony Davis's camp. Rich Paul. Yeah. They butchered this thing. They got nervous. They got tight. They wanted to make some ridiculous deal, which would have shed the Lakers of all their assets. So they demand a trade. Then the dad comes out and says, you know what Boston did to Isaiah Thomas? I'm never sent. My son's never going there. And then of course you go back to the last game of the before the All-Star break. Remember Anthony Davis. Hurt his shoulder so badly he has to go get an MRI, and then he leaves the arena with Rich Paul, and suddenly he's healthy again playing the All-Star game. Like, they massively butchered this thing. So he gets up there, and clearly they had gotten to him and said, like, dude, you just just say he'll go anywhere, they'll win. And so he had a Frank Pantangeli moment. No. You got it all wrong. I'll play for the Celtics. So you still I'll play for the Jazz.
You don't think
I'll play for the Clippers.
For Boston. You think this is just hard?
No, I think that was all rhetoric to try and make them strong on them into sending to LA. Look, remember when Kevin Garnett didn't want to play in Boston because Boston was a racist first town? Right. And he goes there and wins a championship. Now he's a beloved former member. A lot of people say stupid things about an organization before they've ever worked there.
Well, that's why Danny Ainge, and he should, has the utmost confidence that if I get you in Boston for a year, I'm going to convince you to say, number one, they're going to be a very good team.
Right.
Number two, we clearly know how to win championships. We got a great front office, a great coach, great talent around you, even if we do have to trade off a lot of our assets. So he believes confidently in keeping, but I wouldn't give up the farm if Kyrie's not there.
No.
I give up something.
You and I agree. Right. And this is really important to mention. We start with Jason Tatum, and now we're talking about the Celtics and Anthony Davis. And the reason that they're confident, not just because they have Brad's teams, and not just because they've done this before, putting the super team together and win before. It's because when they got Kyrie Irving, he raved about the professionalism. You know, they got a brand new facility, and all these guys are complete professionals. And when you're Anthony Davis, and you've been in New Orleans, they know if they can get him into that building, he'll be like, wow, wait, this is what a real organization's like.
Right.
You got Trey Danny Ainge, who's crushed the world with his trades. You got a professional coach. You got a great organization. You got leaders like Al Horford, who say and do the right things every day. They think he'll be all in because all we got to do is get him in our building. It's like getting a kid on a recruiting visit. Once you get him there, the rest takes care of itself.
Quickly, do you also only think it's 1-3 spots though? Lakers, Celtics, or Knicks? Do you agree with Chris on that?
I do. The Clippers are the one outlier because everyone seems to think they're getting Kawhi Leonard, and you get Kawhi, and you're coached by a guy who's won a championship, and the organization's run on some sense by Jerry West. Yeah. It's still the Clippers, but it's a pretty strong fourth team to add to that.
All right, coming up, did KD enhance his legacy this weekend? That is ahead on First Things First. What's KD doing?